Now, as they were hearing his words, he went on to speak a parable to them, because he was near to Jerusalem, and they were under the impression that the kingdom of God was about to unfold. For this reason, Jesus said to them, "There once was this high-born man who traveled to a faraway land to accept a kingship and return. He therefore summoned 10 of his servants and distributed 10 minas among them. He said, 'Put this money to good use until I return.' Now his subjects all hated him, so they sent the delegation after him to declare, 'We do not want this man reigning over us.' And after being installed as king, the man came home. Then he gave orders that those to whom he had entrusted the money should be brought to him so that he might determine how each of them had followed through on his task. The first one came to him and said, 'Sir, your mina has made another 10. And he replied, "Great work, you able servant. Now because you have proven yourself faithful over something small, take authority over 10 cities.' The second one then approached him and said, 'Lord, your mina has increased fivefold.' Accordingly, he said to him, 'As for you, command 5 cities.' Then another one came up and said, 'Master, behold, here is your mina. I had it tucked away in a handkerchief. You see, I feared your austere disposition. You take what you did not lay down, and harvest where you did not plant.' 'You wicked servant,' he answered him, 'I will judge you by your very words. So you knew me to be an austere man, taking up where I never laid down, and reaping where I never sowed. In that case, would it not have been better for you to have put my money in the bank, so that I could have at least gotten it back with some interest on my return?' And he ordered those who were standing nearby, 'Confiscate his mina, and give it to the man who has 10. At this point they all replied, "But sire, he already has 10 minas." "Even so, I can assure you that everyone who has will be given more. But as for someone who lacks, even what he does have will be taken away from him. But as for these, my enemies, who do not wish to bow to my lordship over them, bring them here and slay them before me." And after he had said all this, he ventured on, leading the way up to Jerusalem.